Hey, we out again. Yesterday it was South Florida. It was beautiful. It was powerful. Today we are going to have baptism now in a fountain. Come on, look at this. Why not baptize in a fountain? This is beautiful. God is doing. We have a lot of people out here. We have the cafe boss just beside us. And here in the middle of Orlando. What? And somebody just got healed from a wheelchair. Come on. There's baptism there. Baptism there. And a wheelchair here. Come on, let's look at this. Come on, they're praying for in a fountain in the middle of Orlando. Don't say that God is not working. God is doing beautiful things. So dear, there, baptism in water and Holy Spirit now. And here, in the wheelchair. Who was in the wheelchair?
She
was. Hey, what happened with you?
I got healed.
You got healed? Come on, from what? What happened with the foot or what?
Yeah, the foot, she had this.
Okay, come on, look here.
You got this.
This, how long time walk with this?
Like 2 weeks, it was okay. A sprain and yeah.
Come on, this is what God is doing. Empty wheelchair, heal for this. And a lot of people around here. We have the cafe bus on the other side. And we have deliverance baptism here in a fountain. Yeah, so God is working. There's so many, many things. I just shared a video from yesterday with powerful healing. You see it and deliverance and baptism. I just shared on my Facebook and YouTube this morning. But that was this morning from what happened yesterday. This is empty wheelchair and baptism in a fountain. What is happening today? Jesus said that we should eat our daily bread. My food is to do the will of him who sent me. We need to live this life. And I love testimonies of what God did 10 years ago or 15 years ago. That is beautiful. But we should not only share testimonies of what God did 10, 15 years ago. We should share testimony of what God is doing today. Every day is new. Now they're praying for the Holy Spirit there. So where can you baptize people? In a fountain. Why not? Where can you pray for people with healing in wheelchair? Every place out there, wherever people is. So this is what God's doing. There's a lot of people here, and it's beautiful.
It is.
Every day, new testimonies.
Absolutely beautiful. Every day, new testimonies.
Every day,
God
new
is
testimonies.
Good. Healing, baptism.
And I have some here. Hey, it's beautiful. Do you love it? Come on. And she asked, I met them. Where are you from?
We're from the suburb of Chicago.
Chicago.
Yes.
And you came down now here. I baptized you?
Yes.
When was that?
July 25th.
Okay.
2020.
2020, July.
Yes.
And you have got a new life.
Yes, I do.
How different is the life here?
It is a radically different life. So I grew up in church and I wondered, would I ever have a life transformation testimony? And in July of 2020, the day before my birthday, I was baptized with the Holy Spirit. I had no idea what that meant until I asked for it. And then water baptized a couple days later. My husband was water baptized again. And the freedom and deliverance over the last several months, I'm free to be filled with the Spirit and full of His fruit and just excited to share. Jesus' name is power.
You know, when you get baptized, when you bury the old life, when you experience a new life, God starts a healing in you. Deep inside healing. I remember after I got baptized, I had a lot of hurt in me still because of my relationship with mom and dad. And then I had a time where the Holy Spirit just went deeper and deeper and deeper, and I started to cry and I started to experience even more freedom.
Yeah.
And that freedom is something that continues. You shall learn the truth and the truth shall set you free. It's not just you learn the truth thing and you are free. It's a continued work.
Yes.
And you experience that because I heard just before that you experienced freedom where your husband actually ended up praying for you also.
Yes.
And it was just like the Holy Spirit came and revealed things in your past.
Yes.
And it came to the service and you pray. Can you share one testimony there?
Yeah, so I learned that the name of Jesus has power over darkness. Because I actually heard, I'll just be completely honest, guys, I heard demons speaking out of me saying, I hate the name of Jesus. And I was broken by that because I love the name of Jesus. But my husband prayed over me using Jesus' name, and the the dark spirits were just leaving and leaving and leaving. It was amazing. And then afterward, the peace and freedom that comes from that is so beautiful. So it's for real.
It is. And I say about freedom, you have to understand that we are free in Christ. We're in buried old life and we can go through a deliverance. But what can happen is that we can think we are free until suddenly God reveals something to us. And I would say, I felt the freedom. I was in love with Jesus. I was telling people about Jesus. And at one time in my life, in the beginning, there was people who said to me, Torben, you're not free. What do you mean, I'm free? No, you push people away. It's not. You are not good to talk about emotion. What do you mean? I talk about emotion all the time. But I had a hurt inside. I had a hurt I did not see. I did not recognize it until a day the Holy Spirit just came over me. Yeah. And I start to cry. And people ask, why are you crying? I don't know. I don't know, but it's good.
Yeah.
And I experience a healing inside. And this is what I love is when you get born again and you get the Holy Spirit, He's our teacher. He's our helper. He's the one who teaches the truth. He's the one who reveals everything to us. And there's freedom.
Yes.
And I would say, don't go and dig inside and focus on, oh, all of that. No, focus on Christ. Let the Holy Spirit work in you and reveal areas in your life. And when He do, don't be afraid to open up and let Him bring light.
And one thing that He showed me was He's cleansing His temple. And we are His temple. And deliverance, basically all it is He is cleansing His temple so that it's fit for use, so that we're vessels fit for use for His kingdom.
And I would say, I haven't met her since I baptized you, I think, or maybe one time after. But they came down to the Keystar with Garrett here in Orlando, and so I saw you again. You are changed. I can see that. Because your background, when I met you first time, I remember the fight in your family and the background, and even you grew up in a Christian family. Most of the things with the Holy Spirit and all that was very new.
Yeah.
And I felt that there was a skepticism, but now it's just freedom.
Yep. Praise God.
Beautiful! Yeah! Thank you. So this is my God's team. Welcome for all of you. Here is the empty wheelchair, woman who got healed just before. And there is a lot of things here she don't need to use anymore because there is power in the name of Jesus. And now He's preaching the gospel there. She just got baptized in the fountain and a lot of beautiful things is happening. So it's a little greeting from here. We have a lot of people out here preaching the gospel, making disciples, and it's beautiful. I want to say to you, I will stop now. I just shared a video from yesterday. With a house, we baptize people in a swimming pool. You can do it. You don't need to do it in a fountain. You can do it in a swimming pool. But just see, the harvest is great. The workers are few. The kingdom of God is growing, and it's just beautiful. Every day, there's new testimony of what God is doing. I just encourage you out there. Love Jesus. Keep it simple. Live this life as a disciple. It's everyone who's called to do it. And just start one by one reaching out to people. If you want to connect with us, go to tlrmap.com. Connect with people near you. See our free movies. It's Sunday today. It's a good movie night. See our free movie on tlrmovie.com. And come and join us. We have a Kickstart in Naples in a few weeks. It's going to be amazing. So a big blessing from here. Bye-bye.
What is your name, brother?